Sarasrara is placed in the limbic area of the brain and is formed from 1,000 petals. When the Kundalini rises up through the central path, after piercing through the various chakras, it penetrates the limbic area. The limbic area is connected to the whole of the brain and also with the nerves. When the Kundalini starts to flow through the nerves, they become gradually enlightened. The vibrations start to spread in all directions. The Sarasrara opens and the Kundalini flows out from our fontanelle bone area that we call Brahmarandhra.
Randhra means the whole, and the Brahma is the all-pervading power of God's love. So it enters into the subtle energy which is all pervading, which we do not feel normally. But then the Chaitanya, the vibrations which are the part and parcel of this energy, all pervading power, the Parama Chaitanya, they start entering into our brain. But Sarasrara is to be kept open is rather difficult for people because it's a vicious circle. First, these vibrations should enter into your brain through the Brahmarandhra when it is opened out, and they should nourish your nerves, by which your left and right side open out, and so more Chaitanya can flow down all these centers. But if your Sarasrara is not properly opened, this process doesn't take place. As a result of that, the chakras don't open. The Kundalini only as very few strands is kept in the spinal cord, and the new strands cannot rise because your chakras are not open. So in Sahaja Yoga it is very important to keep your Sarasrara open.
There is a particular connection between the heart chakra and the Sarasrara.
Already the heart is surrounded by 7 auras of the 7 chakras. And the spirit, the Atma, resides in the heart. As it is, on top of your head here resides the God Almighty Sadashiva. So when Kundalini touches that point, your spirit gets awakened and the light of the spirit starts spreading. And it starts acting on your central nervous system, because automatically the vibrations, the Chaitanya, flow into your brain, who enlighten your nerves. But still, the recognition on the heart is not there. Even without that, you start feeling the cool breeze, you can raise the Kundalini of others, you can cure people, you can do many things. But still, it is not yet felt in the heart so much. That's why we have music, art. All these things start opening your heart. But to go deep down into your heart, what should we do, people tell. Mother, how should we get into our heart? How this mental activity can be performed through the heart? Now you must remember that heart is absolutely connected with brain. Absolutely connected. It's not disconnected thing. If it was, it would not have worked. When heart fails, after some time, brain also fails. The whole body goes out of order. So this mental activity of the heart is to be understood this way, that as soon as you see the danger, without even thinking, in a reflex way, your heart starts pumping more blood and you get palpitation. You don't have to think, there's no mental activity. Just you see, supposing a tiger standing before you, immediately the heart will start pumping. It's a reflex action. Now, how this activity takes place, one may say, is that because it is built in within you, that as soon as you see some emergency, your sympathetic nervous system goes into activity. And you start feeling the fear, you start feeling that there should be some protection, that you should do something about it. But you do not think, you just run. You run as fast as possible. You don't think about it, what I should do, where I should run, just you go on running. Away from the danger. And how do you do that? Because it is built in within you, all this in your brain, that as soon as the heart starts pumping too much blood, it should just make the legs work and the hands work and you should run. Or we can say it is in the central nervous system, built in, the fear. Any reaction, any response like that is built within you. But the response to the spirituality is not yet manifested. It is manifested. It is all built, no doubt, but it is not yet manifested. And how will it manifest? That's what people ask me, Mother, how will it manifest? Through your past, you have learned that you have to be afraid of this, you have to be afraid of that. Also in this lifetime you have learned many things. For a child may put his hand to the candle, won't feel be frightened. But a grown-up will, because an experience. With the experience, gradually you built in that reaction of reflex within you so that you try to save yourself. Now, what experience you should have to build that in your heart is the point. And the experience is of your own divinity, of your own spirituality. Once you start developing that experience, then you know that you are a divine person. unless and until you are aware fully that you are a divine person, howsoever faith you may have in me, the recognition is not complete. So first you have to recognize yourself to be a divine person, to have faith in yourself. We do not have faith in ourselves, though we are such yogis. But if you become introspective and meditative, then you touch that divinity within you. When you touch that divinity, you know you are a divine person. If supposing the sea is responding to moon, that means it has that mobility in it to respond. A stone will not react to the moon. In the same way, in your heart, these waves of these feelings are created by the experience of spirituality, by the experience of your own being, and then you start expressing them. And it is something to be achieved, because you know that the center of heart is placed here. The pitha, the seat of the heart, is on Brahmarath. If your heart is not open, in the heart if you do not have those responses built in, they need not be of awe or fear. But a natural protocol that develops, then you can never do wrong. Because you know whatever is good in your heart. When you are introspecting, then this depth moves further, but more through meditation. That's why I always tell you that please get up in the morning, do your meditation, and get up in the evening and do your meditation. At least before going to bed, you should get to it. That's the only way you can go deeper into your divinity, which is the source of all creativity, source of all the innocence, is the source of all the knowledge and the source of all the joy. Sahasrara was opened out. Because of that you got this mass realization. That's true. But now the quality has to go. Quantity is quite great. The quality has to grow of the Sahasrara. And the Sahasrara is the only instrument which is going to work out Sahaja Yoga in the modern times. If we realize that heart plays the most important role in Sahasrara. Just here is the heart center. How important it is that you have to recognize through your heart, otherwise this center won't open, then how do you get your realization? What a beautiful connection made, that this center here is the seat of the heart, is the pitha of the heart, and this has to open out, then only Kundalini comes. So all this machinery is connected and made in such a manner that you have to understand the importance of heart connected through this brain, which is absolutely integrated with heart. With introspection also you can ask, why can't I recognize that way? Why can't I do that way? What is my interest? Now if you come to Sahaja Yoga for making some sort of a power game, you want to have a power, you are finished. You want to have money or some sort of a business, you are finished. Anything else you try, like making something for your children or for your marriage or family or any such outward things, if you come to Sahaja Yoga, this won't work. But just to expand your heart, to spread your love to everyone, to feel their love within your heart, and then to put yourself into a position when it responds, the heart responds to divinity within you and to your mother with full mental activity of the heart. Today's subject may sound rather difficult for you to understand, but I had to say this one day because we are quite satisfied with a little of the Kundalini coming out of our head. There's so much to come out, so much divinity is there which has to come out. And if you have to ascend, and if you are the foundation of that new age which is going to transform the whole world, we'll have to work hard. May God bless you.
Stay still for some minutes in silence. Allow your attention gradually to rise from the heart to your Sahasrara.